In this video, we'll be talking about secondhand installation for freehand watches, such as some of the most commonly modded watches with Seiko 7S, 4R, or NH movements, as well as watches from our DIY kits. If you would like to know more about hour and minute hand setting, as well as the basics on how to adjust the level and height of watch hands, please check out part 1 of this video. Secondhand installation can be a bit challenging. The trick is to check carefully before applying any pressure. Installing it incorrectly could bend the secondhand post and the damage is irreversible. So please do not press down on the secondhand unless you are 100% sure that you've aligned the hand correctly. Let's start by practicing how lightly we can hold the secondhand in place without applying any pressure. For the secondhand, we'll be using a tip with the smallest hole. Hold the secondhand in place on a flat surface as shown. Use the weight of a hand installation tool to keep it there. Try to get a feeling on how you can keep the secondhand balanced without any downward pressure. We'll cover 3 methods on secondhand positioning in this video. If any of these methods work for you, please feel free to skip forward to the marker highlighted above. For this whole section highlighted in green, I'd recommend watching it through once to enjoy and soak up the content, and then pick up the tools and follow along a second time. The first method involves balancing the second hand on the correct post, and then loosely setting the second hand using the hand installation tool. Position the second hand so that the second hand tube is resting only on the smallest post. Try to keep the second hand as level as possible when you place it on the post. It should make it a lot easier. With broached or broken in hands, you might even be able to place them on the post like this. Now, carefully rotate the setup and make sure the second hand is indeed resting on the correct post. Using the technique we practiced on the previous exercise, use the hand installation tool to balance and loosely set the hand. One of the most common questions we get is how much pressure is needed to loosely set the second hand. Imagine a glass of water. The weight of this glass of water approximates the maximum pressure that you can apply to loosely attach the second hand. If you have second hands that won't stay balanced on the post unless you attach them, we can try method 2. This is a step harder than method 1, but should work for all second hands. Use the tweezers to position the hand, and use the hand installation tool's weight to keep the hand in place. While keeping the hand balanced, check the setup from multiple angles to make sure the hand is in the correct position. Then, we can loosely set the hand. The third method is very common among watchmakers. With experience, we learn to feel for the correct position. To begin, we can place the second hand off to the side intentionally to observe the incorrect position, and then find the slightly higher position, at which we can be rather certain that the correct post is holding a second hand up. Using the hand installation tool, by very slightly trying to move the second hand around with just the weight of the tool, we can tell if the second hand tube is held in place by the smallest post, or if it is sliding around the post. Once we are sure that it's in the right position, we can loosely set the hand. Now, push the crown all the way in. Wind the movement slightly and gently shake the setup like this. Your second hand should start rotating if you did everything correctly. We'll then proceed to set the height and level of the second hand in the next section. If the second hand starts moving as it should, then we can slowly press down with a bit more pressure while keeping the second hand level and not touching the minute hand below. The pressure required should be less than that of what's required for the minute or hour hands. The second hand getting stuck either by the minute hand or the crystal above is the single most common reason behind our students' malfunctioning watches. Time to give the whole assembly a final check. If all the hands function as they should and are low enough and level enough, congratulations. You have acquired one of the most important and rewarding skills of basic watchmaking and watch modding. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more watchmaking tutorials and tips.